City Council District 7 contains Hamilton Heights, Manhattanville, Morningside Heights, and a piece of Manhattan Valley on the Upper West Side. It's a heavily residential district. It has a large number of small businesses, and it's one of the densest districts in the city. It's an incredibly diverse district, and especially large Latino, Jewish, and African-American communities calling it home.
It includes landmarks, everything from Columbia University and City College to the hospital up at 168th Street, community spaces, parks and organizations, restaurants, and so much more.
Morningside Heights and Hamilton Heights are historically very diverse. African American and immigrants, mostly from Dominican descent. It's an ever-changing community.
So the housing opportunity in the district is the single biggest issue that we all face. The district, as I mentioned, is heavily developed and already very dense, so there's a limited number of development sites where new housing can be built in the district. That means that for many of the families facing severe rent burdens, the priority has to be how can we make our existing housing either affordable or keep it affordable. There's been a huge uptick over the past several years in landlord harassment of tenants with the goal of pushing them out and bringing in higher income and possibly more transitory tenants. And also, the biggest issue facing the district is the need for a comprehensive neighborhood rezoning in Morningside Heights. Morningside hasn't been rezoned in almost 60 years, and you see it with the growth of some of these super tall luxury condominium towers that offer no amenities to the community and instead create more high luxury opportunities for folks who don't live in the district.
Gentrification has created huge income disparities between very wealthy community members and community members that are really struggling to get by. This becomes a particular issue when income is used as a marker for things like access to kindergarten and pre-kindergarten programs, when income is used as a marker for determining need of resources like after school, like food security, like senior services and more, because then average income hides the true disparities and the true needs of the district of our lower income community members. In District 7 specifically, with healthcare, one of the things that we are seeing is that vaccination rates are much lower here than in other places across New York City. That means that we need to do a lot of work to make sure that our neighbors feel comfortable getting the vaccine and have a place where they can easily get the vaccines they need.
In the next round of City Council, they have a challenge to try and retake commercial rent stabilization, because what was happening is that these rates are escalating so high every year, and the landlords have so much power upon the commercial tenants that it is almost impossible for the commercial tenants to sustain growth.
Now more than ever is when we need a city council that is ready to push for transformative change. If we are to truly recover from this pandemic and have a just recovery, one that prioritizes New Yorkers that have been hit hardest, we need a city council that is prepared to take bold, transformative change rather than just incremental change that tinkers at the margins.
To balance things out a little, that's mostly what a person that sits on the council would need in order to serve this community at this point in time.
Our community will only get stronger and be able to recover better than before from the pandemic if the next council member takes a very proactive and almost organizing approach to working with key stakeholders in the community to make sure everybody in our community is informed, engaged, and part of the solution to the problems that we collectively face.